5 years ago, I graduated college with a perfect GPA, but no job. With just a laptop and the internet, I started learning to code. Within a year, I landed several internships and now working at LinkedIn as a senior software engineer. Along the way, I did some things right, made mistakes you can avoid. If I could go back in time, this is how I would do it. Let's get into it. First, it's mindset. It's the middle of the night, you are working on that programming assignment. You've tried everything you can think of, but you still get the error, no pointer exception. You are on the edge of giving up, and you start to question yourself whether you made the right decision of learning to code. And this is the first mistake I made when I started off. I freaked out when I ran into an error. I wasted so much time and energy being frustrated instead of reading the error message carefully. Oftentimes, if you Google the error or ask ChatGPT, you'll probably find the solution. The worst thing you can do is to give up. It's okay to fail. Most people do, actually. What keeps you going is knowing there's a solution. You just need to find it. So next time you see a red arrow pop up, remember, it's a clue. They are like little detectives pointing you in the right direction. Nowadays, if my code runs perfectly on the first try, I get suspicious. Errors are not scary because
we fix it.
And that brings me to the second point, debugging. Debugging might seem like a never-ending nightmare. Sometimes you feel that anything that can possibly go wrong will go wrong. But debugging is actually the most important skill any developer can have.
The art of debugging is figuring out what you really told your program to do rather than what you thought you told it to do.
Here are a few tips. First, using print statements often. We have a simple Java program that finds the average of an array of numbers. Let's run the code and error message. It tells you which line has a potential issue. In our case, line 13. Let's insert some print statements. One before the loop, one inside the loop, and one outside. Since it didn't reach outside the loop, we know something is wrong inside the loop. Let's read the print values. So you realize we are trying to access something that doesn't exist. We only have 5 values here, but we are trying to access the 6th one. Second tip is to set breakpoints. We can set breakpoints at the same place where we put the print statements and run in debug mode. When the debugger pauses at the breakpoint, let's inspect the values. We step through the loop and see how the values change. And you can see here is the same issue as before. We are trying to access something that doesn't exist. The fix for this issue is to remove the equal sign here because we started with index 0. And voila, it fixed the issue. It's a simple example, but you get the idea. The third tip is logging. The print statements I showed are temporary changes that print value to console. You should delete them after they have served their purpose. Logging, on the other hand, is a more formal process that prints out text in a file. It is the most useful in production environment. I use logging and breakpoints most often at work. Keep in mind, computers are logical, and there's always a logical explanation for the problem, even if it seems too hard at the moment. Now you have the right mindset and know a few debugging strategies. Next is to choose your first programming language. The language you choose to learn at first doesn't have to be the same language you eventually use at work. I started with Python and C++ and use Java and TypeScript during internship and at work now. You just need to pick one and learn it well. I would recommend Java as the first programming language for 2 reasons. First, performance. Java is much faster when it compares to Python, because Java is a compiled language. The errors in Java can be called a compile time, and they're more descriptive. Second, Java is a statically typed language. In case you don't know, statically typed means whenever you are creating variables, you need to state what's the type of that variable. When we compare to dynamically typed language like Python, you don't need to provide any types. Your code will run faster with strongly typed language like Java and will be easier to read and understand. Once you've learned Java well, you can pick up any other languages very easily. Technologies come and go. Your ability to learn stays. To learn Java, you can read books, watch YouTube videos, take classes from Udemy. But the most important thing is focus on one thing and finish it. And that is the second mistake I made. I tried to watch too many videos at once and didn't finish 95% of them. I would tell the old me to just choose one, choose anything in fact, and just finish it. In the early stage of learning to code, it's better to pick a mediocre class, but to finish it from start to end. For beginner, I would recommend Mosh's Java tutorial on YouTube. It covers basic topics like variables, strings, arrays, classes, control flows,and so on. And next is project. The best way to learn programming is by doing. There's a saying by the famous Chinese philosopher Confucius. I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. I do and I understand. You can start small by building a tic-tac-toe game, for example. There are tons of examples on YouTube where you can follow. But don't just copy the code. Make your own twist. This is actually the third mistake I made. I used to copy code line by line. Thinking back, it's just a waste of time. That was not active learning. When you make your own twist, you will run into bugs. Don't freak out. Have the right mindset and diligently debug your error. And this is some video game I made in earlier days. I would recommend to pick up a full stack project, which involves a front end, a back end.Some API layer, and a database. For me, I took the Web Developer Bootcamp on Udemy. It covers basics you need to know to build a website using HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and MongoDB. The only caveat is that it's not free. The free resource I recommend is CS61B course by Professor Josh Hugg. This class is in Java. Not only it gets you through building a project, it teaches you data structures and algorithms. And that brings me to my last point. Learn data structures and algorithms. Eventually, you want to get a job. For interviews, you want to be familiar with data structures like strings, arrays, hash maps, trees, graphs, queues, stacks, tries,and heaps, along with some basic algorithms like breadth first search, depth first search, sorts, and recursion. To learn this, except the CS61B I just mentioned, I would recommend a free course on Coursera, Princeton Algorithms. This class is in Java, and the best platform to practice data structures and algorithms is LeetCode. Well, that's all. I wish you good luck with everything that is to come in 2024. The journey won't be an easy one, but I promise you, it will be a fulfilling one. I hope you like this video, and I'll see you next time.